Hey there, what is going on? Today I'm going to show you how to become a master of navigating in your Flutter app. By the end of the video, we're going to make this app go everywhere we want. Screen 1, return home. Screen 2, return home. And notice how when we return home, the arrow disappears. And we can just keep on going screen after screen. And then once you hit the return home, you go all the way back to the stack and there's no back arrow at all. While if I hit it like this, and then I hit the back arrow, we gotta go all the way back, but you won't have to do that because you're gonna be a navigating master, so stick around for it. I'm going to leave the link to this documentation in the description, and we're not going to waste any time right here, but this is essentially a sum up of this video. If you don't understand anything, you can just check this page out and see if the answer to what you want is right here or not. And what I want you to see right here is the terminology. In Flutter, screens and pages are called routes or routes, however you want to pronounce it. And the route is essentially like you live here and you got to go to work here, so you take this route to work. That's pretty much what a route is. So what you essentially do in Flutter is you create the routes and then you navigate using either Navigator.push or Navigator.pop. That's essentially it. And why are they called push and pop? Well, that's because you need to imagine your app like a stack, and you can just come here and do stack of plates, for example. And as you can see, it's a stack. There's a plate on top of each plate. For example, you can also search stack of pancakes, for example. That's a stack as well. And that's how you gotta imagine your app. You need to imagine that each page is kind of like a pancake or a plate in a stack of pancakes or plates. Let's go to Android Studio to see this in action. So here we are in our homepage with a button going to screen 1 and another one going to screen 2. But right now if you click either one, nothing happens. So let's take care of that. So first let me address the simplest way to navigate to another page, which is navigator.push. And you take the context and you then here on the root, you use material page route. Let me just add this here and this here. And within the builder, you also give it a context, and then you return the page you want to go to. Now, this page right here is called screen 1. So what you want to do here is type in screen 1. And usually when this shows up, if you press enter, it will automatically import it. And in this case, it did, as you can see right here, it's imported. And then if I save this, I can already go to screen 1. As simple as that. And then to return, all I gotta do is hit the arrow right here and you go back. And now let's take care of screen 2. I'm just gonna copy this and paste it here. And this time I'm not gonna press enter to automatically import it. So when this happens, all you gotta do is alt and enter. And right there is the option to automatically import it. You just gotta press enter now. And once again, it has been imported. And of course, if I save it and I click screen 2, there you go. And this is exactly what I was talking about before with the plates and the pancakes. Right now, if I press this, the stack goes back to only one page. But once you go to screen 2, there's two pages. So there's two pancakes or two plates. That's how you gotta imagine it. Then if you go to screen 1, there's three pancakes right now. So on top is the screen 1 and we take it out. We'll go back to screen 2 and then we take out the screen 2 and we go back to the home. Now, when you go to screen 1, if you wanna go back to home, you could come here and paste it again. And instead of screen 1, you do home, then you'd hit save, and this would work. You would return home, but as you can see, the arrow to go back is right here. That means you just added something onto the stack. So if you come back, you go to screen 1, then you go back to home. So technically, you can go to screen 1 and then add another stack to go home, and then go to screen 1 again, and then add another stack to go home. And right now we have quite a big stack, so in order to go back all the way to the first pancake, or to the first element of the stack, we gotta go all the way back. We gotta remove all of the stacks that we put on top of each other. And that's no bueno for your app's performance. Which is exactly why, instead of this right here, what you should do instead is navigator.pop. That's what makes you return to where you came from. And you gotta add a context here, and that's it. I'm going to save it, and now if I do screen 1 and then return home, it popped from the stack. There's no back arrow anymore. And that's exactly how you want to go about it. The thing is, if you come over to screen 2, it also says right here, navigator.pop to go home. So I'm going to show you something. I'm going to go to screen 1 and now I'm going to go to screen 2. And if I press the back button, I go back to screen 1, right? But going back to screen 2, if I press return home, I don't return home. I go back to screen 1. And that's a problem, because that's not what we wanted at all. If this does happen to you, then for example here, instead of navigator.pop.context, just to make sure you don't end up with a bunch of stacks on top of stacks on top of stacks, making an infinite amount of stacks, you can do instead navigator.pushReplacement, and now you just do pretty much the same thing. Again, use the context here, and let me just add these little details. And here you return the home page, which I already imported this page. And now if I save it and I do this, go to screen two, and I do return home, although it doesn't go back to the original home, you didn't add on to the stack. You removed the screen two from the stack and you added the home to the stack. But there are other solutions as well. For example, in this case, you specifically know how many pops we would need to go back home. We go from home to screen one and then from screen one to screen two. So we need two pops. 1, 2 to go back to home. So if you do know how many pops you need, all you gotta do instead of this right here is you gotta create a variable like so. And then here you would do navigator.popUntil context. Everything's loaded up straight away. That's great. Thank you, Android Studio. And then as you can see, the first argument is the context, and then you return when this is true. Now if I save this, and again screen one and then screen two, if I tap return home, the arrow disappears, as you can see. So we have pops twice. We are exactly where we want. But this is only if you know how many pops you need. If you don't know how many pops you need, in that case, you do navigator.popUntil. And that's exactly why you get this root value right here when you use this method, because now you can do root.isFirst. So if you ever need a button that makes the user return all the way back to the first index of the stack, then this would be what you would use. Now, if I save this, and again, we do screen one and screen two, and I tap return home, we go all the way back to the first page or route of the stack. You can have 20 stacks, doesn't matter. With this code right here, you go back to the very first part of the stack. So obviously, in this case, we just take this and also use it right here, because whenever we want to return home, we want to remove all the elements of the stack and just go back to the first element of the stack. And now let me show you how to navigate with named routes. I'm going to leave this document in the description as well, but I'm just going to go ahead and show you how to use it. Essentially, this is for when your app has a lot of different screens, and the goal is to make your life easier when changing screens and when applying the screen changes, etc. Because if you have 20 plus screens, you'll go crazy, always having to go back to the page and see what the name, etc. And also, it's a more organized way to go about things. So instead of the home property right here, you use the initial route property. And this takes a string. Usually, you use this as the home, because that's just how programmers have been doing it for years. But then you gotta come over here and you have to use the routes property, and as you can see, it takes a map of string and then a widget function. So you need to use the curly braces right here, and because this is a map, you start with a string and then that string equals to something. That's usually how maps work. And since it's a function, that this is exactly how you start, and you use the context here, and then you return the screen corresponding to what you want. In this case, we want the home screen because this is the initial route that we're setting. And then here we can set screen one, and the rest is the same. You return screen one, and it's the same for screen two. Just gotta change the numbers and import this. If I hit save, everything will still work the same, but we haven't really applied the code. But before we do anything else, let me just show you that you cannot do this. You cannot have a home property set alongside the initial route. If I save this, it breaks the app. You can only have either the home property being used or the initial route property being used. Now we can go back to the app working, and let's go over here to home. And on the screen one right here, instead of navigator.push, we're going to do navigator.pushNamed. Like so. It's very similar, except instead of using the material page route, all you gotta do is use the string we just created for it, like so. So this is much simpler, as you can see already. And if I hit save, now press screen one, no surprise, we go to screen one. And push named also has, as you can see, push replacement named if you wanted to replace like we did before. But in this case, we don't want to do that because we always want the home stack to be there. And in this case, all I would have to do here is this, and it works, by the way. But the reason you don't want to ever replace the home stack is, well, let me just show you. Let me uncomment this. Let me save this. And we are in the very first element of the stack. And I'm going to pop it. And we're in the black hole. The app no longer is functional because you have no buttons. You are not in any pages whatsoever. And this is exactly why you should never replace the home page of the stack, because you want your app to work. And finally, if you're afraid to fuck something up with a typo because this is just a string, and you know, if this says this, Android Studio is not going to tell you there's an error because it's just a string. So if you want to use variables instead of strings, that can be done too. You can come over here, for example, to screen one, and you can create a static final string and call it screen one, for example. You can call it whatever you want, and then it equals that string that we just created. And now that this is done, all you gotta do is come back here, and instead of using this right here, you say screen1.screen1. And let's do the same for screen2 as well, like that. And then the same right here, screen2. And usually nobody does this here because the initial route is so simple, you know, it's just a piece of string. So there's not much point to it, but if you want, go ahead. It's up to you. But anyway, if I save this and I click it, it won't work for now because of this crazy name I gave it. But this actually will, even though it's not using the variable, the value of the variable is still this. But what we want is to not use strings. We want to use the variable. So you probably already know this. This is what you got to do. Same here. And then you hit save. And of course, everything works just fine. Return home. And that's about it. We can just create a bunch of stacks. And then at the end, I'll just do this. And we go all the way back to the initial stack. This is most of what you'll ever need in your Flutter apps. If you got this locked down, you won't really need to know many more details. So I hope this video helped you. If it did, please drop me a like. And if you wanted to keep on learning Flutter, do not forget to hit the subscribe button. Thank you for watching. This is Flutter Mentor. And out.